people, people with weak hearts, people with weak anything. Jonathan Porritt. In fact, all environmentalists, except David Bellamy. You can stay, David, because I know you like cars. Doctors, magistrates, Linfold's Wood, caravanners, and politicians. Right, now we got rid of that lot, let's have some fun. But, would you just look at this? This is an open vehicle. Drive carefully. No. While the rest of America is talking about electric cars and a need to conserve fuel, Chrysler is talking about this. Its new Viper, a 165-mile-an-hour, 8-litre Leviathan. For those who don't want to pussyfoot around at 2 mph in a solar-powered box, this is a dream come true. A throwback to the days when Cobras ruled the roads and performance was king. This car kicks ass. Today, most so-called sports cars are heavy and decadent, but this one is different. You could almost call it Spartan. I'm untroubled here with a roof, and the only reason there are no electric windows is because there are no windows at all. There's no cruise control, there's no electric door mirrors, but there is air conditioning. A lot of air conditioning. This no-frills part means the whole car weighs just 3,200 pounds, which isn't bad when you remember it's 15 feet long. It especially isn't bad when you consider the monster that lives under the bonnet. Big, isn't it? Big, but not complicated. There are no turbochargers, there are no superchargers, there aren't even 4 valves per cylinder. So what is it then? Well, this is an all-aluminium 8,000cc V10 track engine. Let me put some figures on it for you. 400 brake horsepower, 450 pounds-feet of torque, 0 to 60 in 4.5 seconds, 0 to 100 and back to naught again in 14.5 seconds. Mind you, I should just tell you that Chrysler owns a little Italian company, Lamborghini. So no prizes for guessing where they went to when they wanted help designing this little baby. Mind you, both of them seem to have forgotten to have put any door handles on it. You have to reach inside to open the door. Once more, into the breach. Unbelievably, at slow speeds, this automotive volcano is as quiet and as unassuming as Lincolnshire. The ride is superb. You'd expect those massive low-profile tyres to bounce if they even so much as smelt a cat's eye. But no, you could drive through an earthquake in the Viper, and it would feel as docile as an E.M. Forster novel. Mind you, if you want to turn Helena Bonham Carter into a snarling Arnold Schwarzenegger, all you need do is drop a cog on the 6-speed box, mash your foot into the carpet, and then all hell breaks loose. You don't drive this car, you just hang on. It's like riding an atom bomb. I tell you, it makes the rocket look about as exciting as a deep freeze. Against this, the Diablo's like Winnie the Pooh. So, this car has all the sensitivity and social responsibility of a tomcat. It's no good, I have just got to have one of these cars. I've got to. Those who have £50,000 lying around will soon be able to turn my dream into their reality, because next year the Viper will be launched in Britain. Right, one final word, just in case any of the sensible people have crept back into the room, luggage space. Well, as you'd expect in a car with no windows, it's not that great. But there is room for one of these. And let's not be downhearted, let's look on the upside. Very useful for getting the bugs out your teeth. Well, I'm off now. I'm gonna go rob a bank.